Hi, Jonathan here. Today is 11th of July 2021. The time right now is 9:18 p.m. and this week is gonna be a volatile week. Why? Mainly because if you notice, this is the third week of option expiration, third week of the month, which means this is an option expiration week. Plus, not only that, if you take a look, okay, in terms of news, we have China news again. Okay, we not only have China news, we also have the start of the major start of the earnings report. I think this Tuesday will be the JP Morgan. So the banks are coming in with all the reports, wondering whether, hey, are they doing well or not? Not only that, we also have the yields drop, massive drop last week. Okay, so I'm going to share with you a little bit. But if you notice, last week, there is a major IPO, and the major IPO is Didi. This is the China version of Uber. And did you notice that immediately right after IPO, about 3 days later, they got clamped down for investigation by China government? And there's a change in sentiment in the sense that, hey, the China government basically let them IPO as compared to Ant. Remember Ant? Ants didn't even manage to get IPO, but this time there's a change of strategy. Let them IPO, let them get all the money, and then we clamp them down. So right now, change of strategy basically. But on DT, if you notice on Friday, there is a bullish candle. Perhaps there could be some good news. However, you notice that lately, there's an IPO and there's a lot of major technological company, tech company that got clamped down. So the world is watching this very, very carefully. Okay. And right now there is a US expand their economic blacklist and China is not very happy with that. Not only that, we also have the yields been dropping. Major dropped. Okay. Now this is basically yield go down. That means bond price go up. So that means there is a sudden surge of interest to buy bonds. Now, this strategy, you may not have thought about it for quite some time because it hasn't been happening for quite some time. But you will realize that usually when people go back into buy yields, that also signifies that perhaps the stock market will start to drop. Not immediately, but there is fear. So people like want to sell their stock and go back to bonds because bonds is safer. Will this be a sign? We shall watch the market. Okay, and this is S&P. S&P broke all-time high again on Friday. If you notice that, let's take a look at the 24-hour S&P. That's the all-time high. And on this day, I basically sent out a yellow alert. Oh, by the way, if you want to know, the yellow alert is in the Telegram. Okay, watching this in YouTube, do remember to join Facebook Gathering of Traders. And you notice I did some upgrades right there. And the upgrades, in order for you to effectively use the upgrade, go to Gathering of Traders, click on the more under the files. There is a document here that says Harami Candle and Money Pot Light. There are links in there and documents in there. Show you how to use the signal, where you notice that these are the upgrade I've been busy for you guys in Gathering of Traders for the last 2 weeks, and you get easily visually. But if you blindly use this chart by itself, you realize that, hey, it doesn't work mainly because you need additional support and resistance for the strategy. So that's why I read the document, so that you are able to effectively use this signal to help you to make profit. But in this case, this was a break even. Get out by the fourth candle if there's not much profit, and luckily, or else continue to go higher. So it's inside the Gathering of Traders, more files, Harami Candle and Money Pot Light. And of course, you're watching this in YouTube, please do remember to subscribe. Really appreciate it. Please like this YouTube so that helps Google YouTube algorithm. And of course, please let your friend know about, hey, this crazy guy, nothing to do on Sunday night, talk about the market. Okay, so I appreciate it very, very much. All right, let's go to the market. So if you take a look at S&P, it broke the all-time high. I came out with a yellow warning saying that be very, very cautious, okay, on Thursday. However, the rebound on Friday was so bullish that it closed higher, become a bullish engulfing. So the yellow alert may no longer happen. So take note of that, because the Friday candle, I was expecting the Friday candle, if the rebound was small, expected, right? Because it's Friday. If you notice, most of the Fridays are a green day. And if you notice, major, whenever there's a major black candle, see here, black candle, major black candle, major black candle. See, every time there's a major black candle, the market just, hey, it's cheap, let's buy. And the market recovered a lot higher than that. So the market have been training a lot of people that says whenever there's a major sell down, it's a good opportunity to buy. That's good. That's good. Why? So that the next time, whenever there's a major sell down, you notice that this, there's a 50-day moving average right here. Every time there's a major sell down, it touches the 50-day moving average, it rebounds higher. Good. So next time it has a major sell down and it touches the 50-day moving average, I'll be watching this S&P very, very closely, because if the next candle close below and confirm that it's a break of 50-day moving average, then that will be the start of a major profit taking. Now just minor profit taking, okay? Just that I'm watching to see whether can we close below and confirm we go below. That's when the bears will start to attack. Now, the good thing is, every time there's a major sell down, you know, basically is the best. If you watch the any war movie, you realize that the enemy won't just go all out attack. The enemy have to send a scout, a spy, to find out where does the good guy or the bad guy put all their soldier. So you notice that whenever there's a major sell down, it's actually the bears sending out a spy to find out where are the bulls positioning their soldier. So every time these are all the major sell down, notice here, it sent a spy, push it down. Oh, the bulls are here. When a double confirm, is the bulls really there? All right, we now know this is where it is. This is where it is. And right now, we know that this is where it is. And this is where the bulls are positioning their soldier. So in other words, in technical term, these are the major support lines that you should be watching. And you can close and confirm that. That means if we can go below 4290, round number, then the next time, if it is going to fall fast and go falls down to 4150, and then 4057 and 3891. 4057 will be very, very strong, will be a very, very strong support, mainly because by the time if we do come down, there's high probability this 200 will about to, this is the reinforcement, okay? The reinforcement, oh, enemy under attack, enemy, we are under attack, under attack, the reinforcement come over, so right here, theoretically will be about, right about there. So 4057 will be a very, very strong. We break that, be very, very careful. Okay, so that's why I love watching war movies, because it does give a sentiment of both sides attacking each other. How do they plan their strategy? And that's how I plan the battle plans for the US 500. Okay, now the thing is, if you notice, Russell, it has been sideways, sideways for a long time. And on Friday, we have a massive bullish engulfing candle, okay? But you notice that if I show you the chart, Dow Jones, look at it, uptrend. Dow Jones has been uptrend. Look at Nasdaq. Nasdaq has been uptrend. Russell is not. Russell has been sideways. So this could be a sign that, hey, be very careful. Could it be that if Russell starts to break down, see, tested the defense line right here? Let's draw maybe this zone. this zone, okay, will be the trench line from between 2128 to 2139, 2140. So this will be the trench line where the bulls are positioning their main artillery and reinforcement is coming in. So all will be right here. So in other words, this will be a very, very strong defense. It's basically, if the bears able to break through this defense line, we're going to go down. So watching the US 2000 very closely at this point too. And if you take a look at the German, basically the Germans, the Londons, all are very similar. When S&P pull higher, the whole market just pull higher. Okay, so Germans did drop on Thursday. Germany did drop on Thursday first before the S&P. And then when S&P dropped, Germany dropped even further. But when S&P recovered, Germany recovered. So now we are watching to see whether can Germany break this line at 15770. Because if we break that, look at that. Look at that. It'll be the all-time high. So if we can close below above, then the bulls are all the way, the bears are scrambling, trying to regroup, reinforce behind enemy lines. So right now, that's where, I mean, the bulls are winning. Like it or not, the bulls are charging, the bulls are winning. So watching this out, okay? And London, unfortunately, is the weaker index because London is not at the all-time high. London is near trying to see whether can we break through this 7145. Watching that very, very closely. Now, Hang Seng. Okay, trying to maintain that 200 weekly support right there. And right now, trying to recapture that 200. Whatever it is, like it or not, the Hang Seng, the China A50, unlike the American and European index, China and Hang Seng are weak. The index are lower high, lower low. So be very cautious. Singapore futures, SG3. Consolidating, but it is not at the all-time high, okay, which is not a surprise because also got affected. However, we got a bullish engulfing candle on Friday, and which means we should be looking out to see whether can we break this 368.2 so that we can go towards pre-flu price. So watching that very, very closely. So if not, if we break below, I mean, we are very close to the defense line right here. If we break this 353, be on lookout to touch this 200. So watching that, okay? Now, take a look at US dollar. I mean, look at that. Look at VIX first. See that? That's why, remember the last week I was talking about this candle? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, this week. Is it this week last week? I remember last week I talked about this candle, baby. Never mind. Okay, so there's a bullish candle right there, and there's a sign that market, see here, upper shadow? Upper shadow tells you resistance, right? That's why not a surprise Friday did drop, okay? The warning came out way before this candle was formed. Okay, so take note. So, US dollar index, major drop for the last Thursday and Friday. Funny, isn't it? When the index dropped on Thursday, by right, US index should go up because of fear, but it didn't. Okay, but it didn't. And on Friday, when market was bullish, it continued dropping. So right now, watching to see whether can this 200 acting as a support at 91.90. If not, watching this. But this is not a good support because the moving average are sloping downward. A good support is moving average sloping upwards. That will be a good support, right? So watch it. But because it's 200, we gave it a benefit of a doubt. So take note. So if we do drop, continue dropping, these are the levels of Fibonacci I'll be watching. So 50, 200 will be in between the 38 and Fibo 50, which is the 38 Fibo is 91.55 and 91.16. So watching that out very closely. And because of the movement in US dollar, it does affect directly and indirectly the gold. Now, today, this week, I'll be watching gold very, very closely because of different strategies are in play. Okay, let me share with you what does it mean. You notice that gold on the daily candle, I mean, look at it, it's very nice bullish, right? But previously, remember I said it must go higher than here? We did, okay? Now the problem is we are trading within this black candle and we haven't closed above this black candle yet. The close, the body of this black candle open price is 1813.18. The thing is, right now, we are being resisted by that 200 EMA, the yellow line. We did close just at the 200, just above the 200 EMA. That's the good news. The bad news is, we got the 200 SMA right there. Okay, so that means we are in a sort of a no man's zone. Remember the North Korea, South Korea, that's in between the DMZ line? That's the DMZ line. South Korea, North Korea, DMZ line. Okay? You'll be noticing I've been watching too many war movies lately. Okay, now, that means right now, gold is trying to break this 200 resistance. So it needs to punch through that 200 resistance. So the 200 is a resistance. But you take a look at silver, it's a different story. That 200 is not a resistance, but that 200 is a support. Okay, a support. So there is a play right here that, hey, one of them got to break. Either the gold 200 is a very strong resistance pushing it down, or silver 200 helping to price to go up. So one of them has to break. I mean, one of them has to happen. So we are in that inflection point whether gold and silver will go down. That means this support will break and resistance for gold hold, or the price of gold and silver now go up. That means this is a support in silver and the gold is a resistance broken. So right now, we are at that zone where gold and silver needs to do something, needs to take action. So all we need to do, we set an alert for silver at 25.52 and set an alert for silver, a risky alert will be right here at 26.47. Why I say risky? Because if I take this high right here, by the time the price moves to 26.77, silver would have already moved up a lot, isn't it? So have to take a short risk where it could be 26.47. Hopefully we go above and touch here and break higher, or we break the support below. If you want to have a safer trade, break that 200 EMA currently at 25.46. Do remember, whatever I share is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. So this week I'll be watching the gold and silver for a price to move. The price got to move, okay? And there is a bullish divergence in gold. Ta-da! Okay, so watching this. So there's a possibility of gold either go sideways, continue consolidating, which silver already are doing right now. And then let's see whether what can happen. Okay, so the resistance for gold to watch out is will be on Thursday high. If we can close above Thursday high, even safer is to close above the 200 SMA at 1828. Then there's a possibility of gold continuing to go on the upside. Okay, so that's the trade. Oil. I love oil. It was beautiful. We had a live trade with the graduates right about here. It came down nicely. And there's a strong rebound on Thursday. Follow through on Friday. This follow through was strong. So it will not be a surprise if oil continue to go up. However, I will still be watching for oil at about this level from 76.33 to about 76.94. Watching to see, can we have a bearish candle right about this region to go lower? If not, if the price action are very strong, then not a surprise for oil, you see here, to break that high. And if we break that high, look at here, we are all at a very, very, all at a very, very strong resistance right here. If we break that high, it won't be a surprise for oil to go right about here at $84. So that's about close to $10 in difference. So, but that's way too far. I'm watching to see this price right now at 76.33 to 76 to 77 to see whether can we have a bearish candle on daily candle for the price to go down. That forms a double top. Watching that up very, very closely. Okay, so overall in summary, do remember right now that we are in option expiration. Market is overbought. The rebound on Friday is bullish. That it won't be a surprise if we have continued slight upside bullish. But you have to be cautious because we are in the overbought. Yes, granted, overbought can continue going overbought. So market can continue to go up unless there is a strong bearish candle being seen. Okay, so Jonathan, signing off till next week. See ya. Bye.